there are these different ideas of Christianity. You have the Calvinists, represented by St. John, who say no free will, everything is predetermined, and you're either predetermined from before time to be in the elect or not, and your free will doesn't have much to do with that. And then there is this aspect of willfulness. From her early days, you know, the torment of growing up as an orphan with her aunt, then in the school of... She has this will that is not always inclined toward good things, and it's not disciplined. And so they discipline her will as well. And there's, it seems to be this tension between what nature has laid out. I mean, there's a number of lines here about nature. It keeps coming up, I guess, on this theme of providence. He'll say, Rochester, the glamour of inexperience is over your eyes, and you see it through a charmed medium. You cannot discern that the gilding is slime at the manor house and silk draperies cobwebs. The marble is sordid slate and the polished woods mere refuse chips and scaly bark. Now here in the woods, all is real and sweet and pure. Nature must be, this is another line later in the book, nature must be gladsome when I was so happy. Another line later in the book, I have no relative but the universal mother nature. I will strike her breast and ask repose. Nature seemed to me benign and good. What is it with all of this nature, and how do we make sense of that and her free will?
Yeah, so another thing that comes up time and time again is violence and the violence of passion. And that can be obviously, as you point out, found in the natural world. There's lots of, I think at one point lightning splits a tree in half after a crucial plot point. There's windswept moors. It's all very gothic. It's all very dramatic. There's a sort of natural violence in people too, original sin, if you're a Christian. And the great task that Jane faces from the beginning as a child, having inherited a set of very unfortunate circumstances, she is an orphan, she is treated very cruelly, is to find self-mastery. And so her passions, she's a very passionate child. She has sort of violent outbursts when she's treated very unfairly and unkindly, is to find a way of dealing with this. And in fact, this is also the same task that Rochester faces. He must learn to temper his passions.